let's first one is called Loretta. I'm gonna I have a couple jokes, but I'm gonna save them until after I get, you know. In a bed, she's my barroom girl. Wears her sevens on her sleeve. Dances like a diamond shines. Tells me lies I love to believe. Her age is always 22. The laughing eyes are hazel hue. Spins my money like waterfalls. Loves me like a one or two. Loretta, won't you say to me, darling, touch your guitar home. Have a little shampoos, play a little and wailing song. My guitar rings a melody, my guitar sings Loretta's fine. Long and lazy blonde,
you are gonna wear them.
I can have a range. Our sweetest at the break.
Prettiest
day in the setting sun. She don't cry when I can't sleep. At least not till she's all alone. Loretta, I won't be gone long. Keep your dancing slippers on. Keep me on your mind a while. I'm coming home, I'm coming. She's my barroom girl. Wears them sevens on her sleeve. Dances like a diamond shines. Tells me lies I love to believe. Rage is always 22. The laughing eyes on the edge of the street. Spends my money like waterfall. Loves me like I want her to. Loves me like I want her to. On the road, my friend, it's gonna keep you free and clean. Now you wear your skin like iron, your breath's as hard as kerosene. You weren't your mama's only boy, but her favorite one, it seems. She began to cry when you said goodbye. You sank into your dreams. Poncho was a bandit boy. His horse was fast as polished steel. Wore his gun outside his pants for all the honest world to feel. Poncho met his match, you know, on the desert stand in Mexico. And nobody heard his dying words. Oh, but that's the way it goes. And all the federales say they could have had him any day. They only let him hang around out of kindness, I suppose. Lefty, he can't sing the blues all night long like he used to. The dust that Poncho bit down south ended up in Lefty's mouth. The day they laid poor Poncho low, Lefty split for Ohio, where he got the bread to grow. Oh, ain't nobody knows. could have had him any day. We only let him slip away. Out of kindness, I suppose. Well, the poets tell how Pancho fell. Left his living in a cheap hotel. The desert's quiet and Cleveland's cold. So the story ends, we're told. Pancho needs your prayers, it's true. But save a few for Lefty too. He just did what he had to do. Oh, now he's growing old. And a few great federales say they could have had him any day. They only let him go so wrong. Out of kindness, I suppose. A few great federales say they could have had him any day. They only let him go so wrong. Out of kindness, I suppose. Talking Thunderbird Blues.
All right.
This is about the first time that I ever had any Thunderbird Martin. Something strange as things I ever heard. This friend of mine said, man, let's go get some Thunderbird. I said, what's that? He just started to grin, slobbering on his shirt, and his eyes have got dim. This will be over in just a minute. No, he said, you got 59 cents. I said, I got a dollar, but don't be a smart aleck. I ain't gonna spend it on some Indian relic. He said, Thunderbird's not an Indian trinket, it's a wine, man. You take it home and drink it. Get back in that normal. I said, it don't sound like wine to me. He said, he bet me the change for my dollar. So hustled on down near a shoe totem. The guy wanted my ID. I ripped out and showed him. He got a green bottle from the freezing vault. My friends started doing backward somersaults to the cottage cheese. Well, we took back to his house, started drinking. Pretty soon I set into thinking, man, this Thunderbird is yum, yum, yummy, and I know it's doing good things to my tum, tum, tum. It's the way you reason when you're on that crack. We got a few more bottles and chugged them down. I pulled myself up off the ground. Decided I'd go see my dear sweet wife. She met me at the door with a carving knife. Said, get them damn grape peels from between your teeth. I can see we're going to have a little misunderstanding. I said, dear, I better get in touch with you later. And she said, forget it, man. You're never touching me again. Now I've seen light and I've heard the word. And I'm staying away from an old Thunderbird. The message come from heaven, radiant and fine. And now all I drink is communion wine. 6 days a week. Blowing Amarillo and a moon along the gun. shine, the sun don't rise. Shall I cast my dreams upon your love bed and lie beneath the laughter of your eyes? The snow and amber tone. Come morning, I'll be through them hills and gone. Ah, mother thinks the road is long and lonely. Little brother thinks the road is straight and fine. Ah, darling thinks the road is soft and lovely. I'm thankful that old road's a friend of mine. Ah, snow. I breathe in them hills and gone. Well, bid the years goodbye, you cannot still them. Oh, you cannot turn the circles of the sun. Well, you cannot count the miles until you feel them. And you cannot hold a lover that is gone. Snow and on return. Come morning, I'll be through them hills and gone. Now tomorrow the mountains will be sleeping, silent beneath the blanket green and blue. All I shall hear the silence they are keeping. I'll bring all their promises to you. All snow and on return. Come morning, I'll be through them hills and gone. The snow and on return. The morning I'll be through them hills and gone. The morning I'll be through them hills and gone.
Here's one called, what's it called? Ain't Leaving You Love. Remember, if anybody ever tells you six, one, half a dozen of another, don't pay any mind to them, because there ain't no such thing as six of one. There's one of one. Heavy, man, heavy. Let's call it. Ain't Leaving You Love, baby. Yeah, Mr. Gator, he's just sliding down the bow. Mr. Buzzard, he's a gliding through the air. Mr. Turtle, be a hitting the highway. If I ain't going nowhere, I ain't leaving your love, baby. I ain't leaving your love, baby. Not for heaven above, baby. I ain't leaving your love. Well, a rich man got him an airplane, cruising through the traffic jam. Well, a poor man got him a Chevrolet. I'm staying right where I am. I ain't leaving your love. I ain't leaving your love, baby. Not for heaven above, baby. I ain't leaving your love. I ain't leaving your love. Well, In the Hannibal, he was a mountain man. See, Patrick did a dancing down in the Nile. Lucky Linda made it all the way to get married. I'm staying right here a while. I ain't leaving your love. I ain't leaving your love. Not for heaven above. Babe. I ain't leaving your love. I ain't leaving your love, babe. I ain't leaving your love, babe. Not for heaven above, babe. I ain't leaving your love. Called the Buckskin Stallion Blues. I wrote this up in Colorado. It's half about a horse and half about a girl, and I still miss such horse. I heard her sing in tongues of silver. Heard her cry in the summer of storm. I loved her, but she did not know it. I don't think about her anymore. Now she's gone and I can't believe it. I don't think about her anymore. If 3 and 4 were 7 only, where would that leave 1 and 2? If love can be and still be lonely, where would that leave me and you? Time there was and time there will be. Where does that leave me and you? Well, if I had a buckskin stallion, I'd tame him down and ride away. And if I had a flying schooner, I'd sail into the light of day. If I had your love forever, sail into the light of day. Pretty songs and pretty places, places that I've never seen. Pretty songs and pretty faces tell me what their laughter means. Some look like they cry forever. Tell me what their laughter means. If I had a buckskin stallion, I'd tame him down right away. If I had a golden galleon, I'd sail into the light of day. If I had your love forever, sail into the light of day. Academic jobs, and I'll just get it over with. And I learned it from the Elvis movie, and you probably never hear it again. Yeah, it was from Girls, Girls, Girls. I thought it was from King Creole, then I saw King Creole at one in there, and I thought, man, I hope I didn't write this gobbler in my sleep or something. But then I saw Girls, 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 and there. First off, you got to imagine me as Elvis. If you can do that, you know, we got this. There's a guy back there playing a 55-gallon oil drum and one over here and wearing the back of a shrimp boat, headed for the sunset. Well, I saw through shrimp in the water, two were old and gray, swam a little bit closer and I heard the third one say, "Goodbye, mommy shrimp. Papa shake my hand. Here comes a shrimp boat for to take me Louisiana." I showed his mama and papa a shrimp newspaper he'd read, with an advertisement which to all the young shrimps said, "Free ride, New Orleans, stay in Grand Hotel. Meet Creole gal to help you to come out of your shell. Meet Creole gal to help you to come out of your shell." His poor mama and papa, they ain't heard from him yet. Last time they saw his smiling face was when he jumped into the net. "Goodbye, mommy shrimp. Papa shake my hand. Here comes a shrimp boat for to take me Louisiana. Here comes a shrimp boat for to take me Louisiana."
That's supposed to be nearly that serious. You know, when the shrimp song starts sounding serious, you get, you know, like seek professional help, Daddy. We'll let's sit and play. Here's one called long did the shrimp song, right? Do the catfish song. I wrote this about a river I lived on in Tennessee. Yeah, down at the bottom of that dirty old river, down where the reeds and the catfish play, there lies a dream as soft as the water. There lies a bluebird just blown away. Well, to me it's like springtime, and to love's like the summer. Her brown eyes shone for nobody but me. In autumn forever the fool come the fall, and the rain turned to freezing inside of me. I'll kindle my fires with the words I can't sing, the roads I can't follow and the songs I can't sing. I wander alone on the sleigh bells of winter, with the stars for a diamond and the world for a ring. Well, all you young ladies who dream of tomorrow, while you're listening, these words will I say. Cling to today with its joy and its sorrow. You'll need all your memories when youth melts away. The angel of springtime, he rides down the south wind. The angel of summer, he does just the same. The angel of autumn, she's blue and she's golden. And the angel of winter won't remember your name. the dirty old river, down where the reason the catfish play. There lies a gleam as soft as the water. There lies a bluebird just blown away. There lies a bluebird that's blown away.
Thank you, brother.
It's the only song I ever wrote that my mother hated. Well, if I had a dollar bill, yes, I believe I surely will go to town and drink my fill early in the morning. Always been a gambling man, rolling bones with either hand. Seven is a promised land early in the morning. Mother was golden girl, slit her throat just to get a pearl. Cast myself into a whirl before a bunch of swine. Little darling was a red-haired thing, man, she made my lips to sing. Gonna buy a diamond ring early in the morning. Long way down the Harlan Road, busted back in a heavy load. Won't get through to save my soul early in the morning. Always keep me in my dying bed, tell me where to lay my head. Not with me is all she said early in the morning. If I had a dollar bill, yes, I believe I surely will go to town and drink my fill early in the morning. Well, let's play this one called Don't Take It Too Bad. Girl, don't you take it too bad if you're feeling unloving, or if you're feeling unfeeling. If you're feeling alone, won't you take it too bad, 'cause it ain't you to blame, babe. Or some kind of game made. But all of this living that we got left to do. Oh, and if you go searching for rhyme or for reason, well, you won't have the time And it takes just for talking at the places you've been, babe, at the faces you've seen, babe. Oh, and how soft the time flies past your window at night. And we just can't have that girl. It's a hard, lonesome, cold world. And a man needs a woman. Or to stand by his side and whisper sweet words in his ears about their dreams. Roses and playthings, and the sweetness of springtime, and the sound of the rain. However long, 15 minutes, I guess, however long, and then be better. This one I call the Talking Fraternity Blues. I was a pledge twice, and once in Colorado and once in Houston, and I never went active, but I wrote this. I decided to improve my social station. I joined a fraternal organization. I tucked in my shirt, signed on the line. Right away they set out to improve my mind. Said, we don't much like the way you walk. You're going to have to change the way you talk. They said your dress is kind of slouchy and your attitude's a little grouchy. They said you got to learn to bubble. You got to bubble with enthusiasm, and I started bubbling. Most important thing you can't forget is learning the entire Greek alphabet. I never did really understand how it's going to make me any more a man, but I learned it. I can rip through that son of a beta backwards in 5 seconds. That's way too serious. Way too serious. When they hit me with some pretty bad news concerning the payment of monthly dues, I never did know where the money went, and I never did know it was real well spent, but I paid it. I ain't no trouble causer. Besides, I figured that's life. If you want good friends, they're gonna cost you. Well, finally got to be party time. I got me a great big old jug of wine. I went back out to the house in about an hour, and everybody's drinking whiskey sours. Brandy Alexanders. Frozen daiquiris, reciting the Greek alphabet to one another. I see I was going to have to do my very best to get myself out of that fraternity mess. I stood right there outside the door. I chugged that wine like never before. Walked inside and bubbled. All over a couple of their dicks. Everything's back to normal again. Of course, there's still lots of room for improvement. Friend, that fraternity stuff's too much for me. Next time, I'm going to join a sorority. Give them something to bubble about.
Slow suicide, plenty running in a place to hide.
just living for you. All my friends, they all agree, ain't me a fool like me. I just tell them, wait and see, girl, living for you. Reload. I tell myself, and I'm trying, that just ain't true. Oh, it just ain't true. I'm still looking for you. Still looking for you. Up in the shadow of the darkest pine, the edge of sweet sunshine, I keep looking till I make you mine. Looking for you. When the curtain tumbles down, I'll be somewhere hanging around with my heart laid on the ground, just looking for you. Looking low and looking high, looking far and looking wide, trying to tell myself that's right, but it just ain't true. Oh, it just won't do. I'm still looking for you. Still looking for you.
Thanks, Sean.
Ride the blue wind high and free. She'll lead you down through misery. Leave you low come time to go. Alone and low as low can be. Well, if I had a nickel, I'd find a game. If I won a dollar, I'd make it rain. If it rained an ocean, I'd drink it dry. Lay me down dissatisfied. It's legs to walk and thoughts to fly. Eyes to laugh and lips to cry. A restless tongue to classify. All born to grow and grown to die. Tell my baby I said so long. Tell my mother I did no wrong. Tell my brother to watch his own. Tell my friends to mourn me now. I'm chained upon the face of time, feeling full of foolish rhyme. There ain't no dark till something shines. I'm bound to leave this dark behind. I'll ride the blue wind high and free. She'll lead you down through misery. Leave you low come time to go. Alone and low as low can be.
Jobs. This was by a Lightning Conference, and it's just kind of a strange song.
Yeah.
I don't want no one. Her hair ain't no longer than mine. I don't want no one. Man, her hair ain't no longer than mine. Nothing but bad luck and trouble, man. Have you buying rats all the time? Now, I took my woman through the hairdresser. Is what the hairdresser said. I can't help your woman's hair, man. But maybe I can help her head. I told him no. Man, if your hair ain't no longer than mine. Nothing but bad luck and trouble. Have you buying rats all the time? I wanted to make a swing out with my mom. And I took her by the arm. I wanted to make my swing out of the rat, jump from her head like one from a burning barn. I told her no. Oh, your hair ain't no longer than mine. Nothing but bad luck and trouble. Have you buying rats all the time? Stars know it's time to shine. Daydreams aloft on dark wings, soft as the sun streams a day's decline. All living is laughing, dying says nothing at all. Oh, babe, and I lie in here watching the evening fall. Well, time flows through brave beginnings and leaves her endings beneath our feet. Walk lightly upon their faces, leave gentle traces upon their sleep. All living is dancing, dying does nothing at all. Babe, and I lie in watching the evening fall. With three dimes, hard luck and good times, low rhymes and fast lines, ain't much to say. Feel fine, feel low and lazy, feel gray and hazy, feel far away. All living is sighing, dying ain't flying so high. Babe, and I lie in here watching the day go by.
wrote this one about. I found out later that Tecumseh Valley and Spencer, all I really, these places in the song really existed in about the same, you know, relation that they did in the song. But I was kind of thinking when I wrote it about Kentucky or West Virginia, and it turns out it's Oklahoma.
But the name she gave was Caroline, the daughter of a miner, and her ways were free, and it seemed to me sunshine walks beside her. But she come from Spencer, across the hill. She said her pa had sent her, 'cause the cold was low, and soon the snow turn the skies to winter. But she said she'd come to look for work. She was not seeking favors for a dime a day and a place to stay. She turned those hands to labor. Well, the times were hard, Lord, and the jobs were few. All through Tecumseh Valley, but she asked around, and a job she found, tending bar for Gypsy Sally. Well, she saved enough to get back home when spring replaced the winter. But her dreams were denied, her pa had died. All the word come down from Spencer. Well, she turned to whoring out on the streets with all the lust inside her. It was many a man returned again to lay himself beside her. Well, they found her down beneath the stairs that led to Gypsy Sally's, and in her hand when she died was a note to cry, "Fare thee well, Tecumseh Valley." Well, the name she gave was Caroline, the daughter of a miner, and her ways were free, and it seemed to me the sunshine walks beside her.
It's called Mr. Mud and Mr. Gold. It's about playing five-card stud. That I used to do before I learned how to flip horns. Well, the wicked king of clubs awoke. Goes to his queen, he turned. His lips were laughing as they spoke. His eyes like bullets burned. The sun's upon a gambling day. His queen smiled low and blissfully. Let's make some wretched fool to pay. And plain it was, she did agree. He sent his deuce down into diamond. His four to heart and his trade of spade. Three kings with their legions come, and preparations soon were made. Devoted club, the day's commander, give him an army face and number. All but the outlaw jack of diamonds and the aces in the sky. Well, he give his sevens first instruction. Spared me a game of studs, stakes unscarred by limitation. Put a man named Gold and a man named Mud. Club filled Gold with greedy vapors till his long green eyes did glow. Mud was left with sighs and trembles, watching his hard-earned money go. Flushes fell on Gold like water, tens are paired and paired again. But the aces only flew through heaven, and the diamond jack called no man free. The diamond queen saw Mud's ordeal, began to think of her long-lost son. Fell to her knees with a mother's mercy and prayed to the angels every one. The diamond queen, she prayed and prayed, and the diamond angel filled Mud's hole. And the wicked king of clubs himself fell face down in front of Gold. Now three kings come to clubs command, but the angels from the sky did ride. Three kings up in the streets of Gold, three fireballs on the Muddy's side. The club queen heard her husband's call, the Lord and the queen of diamonds joy. When the outlaw in the heavenly hall turned out to be her wandering boy. Now Mud he checked and Gold bent all muddy rays, and Gold did call, and smiles melted off his face when Mud turned over that diamond ace. Here's what this story's told. You feel like Mud, you'll end up Gold. You feel like lost, you'll end up found. So amigo, lay them razors down. Delegation to the UN in New York. It's really, and they like it, you know, and I'd be playing along. And they had one interpreter, and I'd be playing along, da, 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 da. And he would, in between when I was playing, he would say, what are you doing? I'd play another line. I'd assume he was telling them the real word. The only time I ever worked through it. Well, I ain't very big for 41. Seems like I never could have any good clean fun. Every time I'd go outside, some big old bully'd come along. Hit me in the face, knock me to the ground, start to kicking me all around. Now, that's not exactly fair, friends. That's wrong. So I got me a paper the other night. I crawled over the sofa and I flipped on the light. Went through the pages till I found the classified ads. Said, take karate from Lee Hung Chow, man. Make your first appointment now. This course is guaranteed to make you bad. Next day I drove the address by the Japanese design. I was real impressed. It looked like a regular house of the rising sun. As I walked inside, I was all alone. I had a funny feeling down in my bones. I was kind of sorry I'd ever even come. A giant Jeff comes through the door. I bet that mother was 7'4" and he looked like he was prone to easy aggravation. The Leon Chow Aki Dung, that's Japanese for feet 5'4" thumb. I tried to explain my entire situation. All right, Yankee self-defense, $200.25. I said, what's the 25 cents for? He said, repairs. I said, repairs to what? And he said, to you. And I thought, man, this ain't gonna do. I thought about a half inch tall underneath that slanted stair. You think he was yelling? I said, I believe I'll go try another place. He said, how so, Yankee don't like my race? I said, now there's a mistake, man, and that's true. I've been for you Japanese all along. You Japanese can't do no wrong. And I thought you got a pretty dirty deal in World War II. He grabbed me by the hand and he gave a heave. I figured that's a pretty good time to leave before he had a chance to do me any definite harm. But my plan worked out in the end, you see. Now no bully's gonna pick on me. Who's gonna hit a fellow with just one arm? The mountains north of L.A. down into L.A. And he wrote L.A. Freeway, you know, the core of L.A. Freeway, and I wrote this. I had to write something and just gobblers in it. Yeah. Hell, the man down at this used car lot tried to sell me four wheels and a trunk. I said, man, there ain't no engine. He said, engine's just a bunch of junk. You don't need no engine to go downhill. And I can plainly see. That's the direction you're headed in. And he handed me the key. I said, no deal. Can't sell that stuff to me. I'm no deal. Headed back to Tennessee. Well, I went to a doctor of the highest order. He said I couldn't have a drink for a year. One glass of wine on my birthday, if my birthday wasn't too very near. Well, he must have put me in a state of shock, as I made it for about 2 weeks. And he sent me a bill, knocked me flat off the wagon, and back down on my feet. I said, no deal. Can't sell that stuff to me. On the old deal, I'm headed back to Tennessee. Well, when true love knocked upon my door, she just barely turned 16. I was a little bit nervous, if you know just what I mean. But I'd heard somewhere that true love conquers all. And I figured that was that. And I started having dreams about being chased out of town wearing nothing but my cowboy hat. It's no deal. You can't sell that stuff to me. On no deal. I'm headed back to Tennessee. Well, I've come through this life a stumbler, friends. I expect to die that way. It could be 20 years from now. It could be most any day. But if there ain't no whiskey and women, Lord, up behind them heavenly doors, I'm gonna take my chances down below. Of that you can be sure. But it's no deal. You can't sell that stuff to me.
I'm an oldie. I'm headed back to Tennessee. There's no deal. You can't sell that stuff to me. I'm an oldie. I'm headed back to Tennessee.
I ain't
ain't much of a lover, it's true. I'm here and I'm gone, and I'm forever blue. But I'm sure wanting you. This sky's full of silver and gold. Try to hide the sun. Oh, but it can't be done. At least not for long. Oh, and if we help each other grow while the light of day smiles down our way, oh, we can't go wrong. Well, time, she's a fast old train. She's here, then she's gone, and she won't come again. Won't you take my hand? Well, if I had no place to fall, and I needed to, could I count on you to lay me down?
This old man that I met in a bar in Houston. I think it's like the first serious song that I ever wrote. I wrote about 10 kind of silly and dirty ones, but the first serious one was this. Sometimes I don't know where this dirty road is taking me. Sometimes I can't even see the reason why. But I guess I'll keep a gambling. Lots of booze and lots of rambling. Lots easier than just a waiting round to die. But one time, friends, I had them all. Even had a paw. He beat her with a belt once cause she cried. She told him to take care of me, headed down to Tennessee. It's easier than just a waiting round to die. Well, a friend said he knew where some easy money was. We robbed a man, and brother, did we fly. But the posse caught up with me, drug me down to Muskogee. And it's 2 long years just a waiting round to die. I come of age, I found a girl in a Tuscaloosa bar. She cleaned me out and hit it on the slide. I tried to kill the pain, bought some wine and hopped a train. It's easier than just a waiting round. But now I'm out of prison. I got me a friend at last. He don't drink or steal or cheat or lie. Well, his name's Codeine. He's the nicest thing I've seen. Together we're gonna wait around and die. All together we're gonna wait around and die.
afraid to see the sun won't shine today. Well, I ain't in the mood for sunshine anyway. Maybe I'll go insane. I got to stop the pain. Maybe I'll go down and see Kathleen. A swallow comes and tells me of her dreams. She says she'd like to know just what they mean. I feel like I could die as I watch her flying by. Ride the north wind down to see Kathleen. The stars hang high above the ocean's roar. The moon has come to lead me to her door. Crystal cross the sand, and the waves that take my hand. Soon I'm gonna see my sweet Kathleen. Soon I'm gonna see my sweet Kathleen. Songs for me, I'm not the one to tenderly bring a soft sympathy. I've just begun to see my way clear, and it's plain if I stop I will fall. I can offer a tear for a pain, just a tear, and that's all. What does she want me to do? She says that she knows the moments are rare. I suppose that's true. And on she goes to say I don't care, and I know that I do. Maybe she just has to sing for the sake of song. Do I think that I am to decide that she's wrong? She'd like to think I was cruel, but she knows that's a lie, for I would be no more than a tool if I allowed her to cry all over me. What does she believe that I'm actually to blame? I can't carry her chains. What does she want me? See that she grieves just because she's been blindly deceived. Maybe she just has to sing for the sake of the song. Why do I think It's me to decide that she's wrong. Oh, but nothing's what it seems. Maybe she'll start someday to realize. If she abandons her dreams, all the words she can say are only lies. When will she see that to gain is only to lose? All that she offers me are her chains I got to refuse. Does she actually think I'm to blame? She really believe that one word of mine could relieve all her pain. Maybe she just has to sing for the sake of the song. Who do I think that I am to decide that she's wrong? Oh, but it's only to herself that she's lying.
Thank you.
Trinity's muddy and the brazzers twice.
Well, the girls of the river, they're full of and they're pretty. The Sabine and the Sulphur, their beauties are plenty. On the banks of the Natchez, there's girls by the score. I never will walk down the Brazos no more.
Molly, lend me a hand. Molly, lend me a hand. Molly, lend me a hand. The Trinity's muddy in the Brazos. Trinity's bloody in the Brazos. Job in California on this trip, and sure it's been fun. Ruth, this is California, right? I go, when I'm home, I always keep track of days by Tuesday, Friday, or garbage days.
Here we go.
I do, I guess I do a couple, three more. Well, it's not, it's nice to have seen Doug. Real old friends. Jerk. Well, I remember one time my wife was in a car wreck, and I happened to be in the car. She was driving, and it was late at night, and there had been a car wreck 10 seconds before us, and there was an exact same model station wagon, and that had been knocked over an entire lane on a two-lane street with a median. And we come over the hill, and it was just like, and I was like stone cold sober and had been asleep, and she'd had a couple of beers, and it was like looking right into a mirror, and we were trying to get this car back to this friend of ours, and I yelled, you know, but it was too late. There were going to be no skid marks, and we hit this car, and nobody was seriously injured. I had a couple ribs and kind of a concussion, a minor concussion, and Janine got bumped on the head right there. And the doctor, the police, after all this got worked out, it was the exact same year car, exact same paint job. Very strange. And Devin and Taylor in Austin, Texas, and I remember the policeman saying to Janine, and after I kind of took control, and then the guy who we were trying to get the car back to came by in a taxi cab. So he joined in the general, all of this, right? And it's the policeman, there was another girl with us who had got bumped on the nose and was hysterical. And this Austin policeman came out and was like, "Will you shut up? Just shut up." And the policeman kind of finally said, "Look, you know, if you want to slap her, you know, I'll look the other way." You know, I told him, "I'm from Fort Worth, I don't slap girls." And I'm starting to go into concussion, and then Blaze arrives, and Janine comes over, and now they had towed the two station wagons off the road by this point, right? I went and sat down in the wrong one. Got this blanket, and I pulled it over myself, and but man, this is the cleanest I've ever seen a lady's car, ever. Right now, I mean, the car's demolished, you know, except the inside, both of them were, right? I'm sitting there waiting for developments, and Blaze come over, and he said, "Man, you're in the wrong car." And I said, "It didn't. That really doesn't relate. I'm just, I don't even, you know, I'm sitting here, I'm letting the car have its space, and I'm using my space. And my space happens to be in this car at the moment." So, well, the tow trucks are coming, and they want you to, the police want you to, you know, and that's usually magic words, you know. So I got up and walked over to the other car, trying to concentrate on my concussion there. And turns out Janine had a parking ticket. So she had to go downtown. This policeman asked her, "Well, miss," and Janine had been real helpful during this whole thing. And there was no drunk driving or anything. It was just like a weird freak out of the blue accident. And the policeman actually asked my wife, Janine, "Well, would you rather go to jail or to the hospital?" I mean, it didn't take her, you know. No matter what the concussion was like or anything like that, that was like, you know, the Tennessee driver's license test. there's seriously a question on there. It used to be, last time I lived there, last time I had a Tennessee driver's license. And this is about it. This is really close, pretty close to the truth. Word for word. It's like, if you're driving along super slab, you know, but an interstate, and you see an 18-wheeler stalled in your lane, and you're in the right-hand lane, and they have this computer deal, you should A, accelerate. And this is really true, man. Accelerate. I got this one right. I missed all I could but one, so I did have a Tennessee driver's license for a while. But you should accelerate and veer around to the left as hard as you can. And B was you should maintain your speed and pass him on the shoulder around to the right. And this truck is hypothetically like stopped right in the right-hand lane of the, you know, interstate. Second was ran to the right. And the third was try to brake, and if not possible, ram into him in the back. Those were the three, right? Anyway, Janine, we went to the doctor the next day. He asked, "You want to go to jail or the hospital?" I was learning, you know, this, that, and the other. The police were, you know, real helpful. And boy, they got that intersection cleaned up fast. And I remember, it was like a long time ago, 5 years ago or so. And Janine had a peyote button, and she said, "Hold on." As soon as she found out she had a boy, she had a traffic ticket. She had to go to jail or the hospital. She comes over to the car. "What's up, babe?" "Well, I gotta go. Oh, boy, I gotta go with this. I gotta go." I was like, "No sweat. We'll be down there in like 4 hours and 1 minute. You know, we'll be at. No sweat." And I said, and the policeman is like standing behind her, holding a flashlight for her to talk, you know, to her husband, right, this, that, and the other before. Boy, they just hated it that they had to take her anywhere, you know. And she was just, oh, she was pitiful, pitiful. And, "Tim, would you keep this for me?" And the policeman's got his flashlight. She reaches in her purse, right in my lap, puts this peyote button, right? Like, you know, I had no idea they were, you know, it's an old traditional, you know, Texas deal, and I never even thought about it in that way or anything, but I realized I'm sitting here, my wife has just run headlong into a station wagon exactly like Blaze's, destroyed Blaze's car. There's like four police cars surrounding me. I have two broken ribs and a concussion. And Janine's going to first to the hospital and then to jail. And she has just put a peyote button in my lap with a policeman, an Austin policeman, holding a flashlight. You know, to, you know, help her with her purse, you know. And so I figured at that point that, no sweat, I mean, whatever. You know, and ended up, Blaze had made the taxi cab stay, and me and the girl with the, you know, the little bloody nose, real little bloody nose, screaming the whole time, got in the taxi cab, and, you know, made tracks. And by the end of the night, I was laughing so hard, finally Blaze, had the cab stop and threw the screaming girl out because it was too much, you know, more than the traffic would bear. And we got Janine out the next day and went to the doctor. It was real fun. It was like a picnic, you know, to the county hospital. And the doctor said, "Well, that I was going to be okay. And I said, you know, you're my kind of doctor. And anyway, he said, but young lady, I think you're gonna have two black eyes here in a day or two. So the next day we woke up, Janine has a lump on her right there on her forehead, like the size of this time a duck egg, you know, or a pigeon egg maybe. And like, oh no, babe, you don't have to worry about black eyes, you know. You don't have to worry about that. That old doctor is wrong. You know how the doctors are. You know. The next morning, I woke up and I got up and went out to this little rat hole we lived in and started the coffee, right? And came back in, you know, and just because of the angle of the vision and stuff, first time I saw Janine that day. She's laying in bed, man, she like, I'm serious. Looked like a raccoon, serious raccoon. And I was still a single man, you know. And I'd been through this, you know, this little trauma. It wasn't much, nothing like that. But, you know, it was time, you know, to move or not to move. It was, you know, a question. And Robert Johnson says, you got to move. You know. No choice about it. And I looked at her with those black eyes and I just could not, leave. Yeah, and that's, we've been together now 6 miserable years. I'll tell you one more Thursday, this late at night, you know, and you know, it's fun to, when it gets down to, you know, I might as well be sitting there, it's fun to make new friends and all that. But when Robert Johnson said, you got to move, a lot of people think, me and Hobart talking about this today. A lot of people think that that means that, you know, you want to have fun, you want to be cool, this, that, that, you got to move. Doesn't mean that at all. It means if you're torn out of the black of pre-birth and thrown into this veil of tears, you know, before you're yanked out again into the black of death, you got to move. It's not like, come on man, you got to move. It's like, you got to move. That's true. You know what I mean? It's like, you know, there wouldn't be no blues if nobody had ever been born. You know? Really, and really, it means that. I've always thought if the world was up to its knees in chickens, live chickens, there wouldn't be any war. There wouldn't. You couldn't get to the defense plant. You couldn't get to anything. I mean, it'd be up to your elbows in chickens, right? You'd never be hungry. Wait a second. Mosey onto a tune, I guess. I sing this song wrong just because I hadn't had time to really to learn it. And it's a beautiful song by Bruce Springsteen. And it's a song, and I don't do it nearly justice, but you know, I do it and mean it, so as close as y'all are gonna get tonight. Yeah.
got a 69 Chevy with a 396. Julie heads in a hearse on the floor. She's waiting for me down in the parking lot at a 7-Eleven store. Me and my partner, Sonny, built her straight out of scratch. Night rides with me from town to town. Go for the action, we can't match. We shut them up and then we shut them down. Go for all the money we can meet. When the strip shuts down, we run them in the street. From the fire road to the interstate. But tonight, tonight, the strip's just right. I'm gonna blow them off in my first heat. Summer's here and the time is right. We're racing in the street. I met her on the strip 3 years ago in this Camaro with a dude from L.A. He blew that Camaro off my back. I drove that little girl away. But tonight, tonight, the strip's just right. I'm gonna blow them off in my first heat. Summer's here and the time is right. We're racing in the streets. But some guys, they just give up living. Start dying little by little, piece by piece. Some guys get off work, go home and wash up, and go racing in the streets. But tonight, tonight, the highway's bright. Out of our way, Mr. You Best Keep. Summer's here and the time's right. We're racing in the streets. All you shut down strangers and hot rod angels rumbling through this promised land. My baby and me, we're gonna drive to the sea. Wash these sins off our hands. But tonight, tonight, the strip's just right. I'm gonna blow up in my first heat. Summer's here and the time is right. We're racing in the streets. I got a 69 Chevy with a 396. Julie is in a hearse on the floor. She's waiting for me down in the parking lot of a 7-Eleven store. Me and my partner, Sonny, we build her straight out of scratch. And we run it from town to town. Take all the action we can match. We shut them up and then we shut them. On tonight, tonight, the highway's bright. Out of our way, Mr. You Best Keep. Summer's here and the time is right. We're racing in the streets. Summer's here and the time is right.